Tonight, we're going to see one of the greatest rivalries in wrestling history possibly come to the end in Kyle Dake and Jordan Burroughs' last potential matchup ever. So it's going to be crazy to watch in this best of three series to decide who goes to Tokyo, but we got our predictions and our keys to victory for each wrestler in this video. Kyle Dake and Jordan Burroughs, some of the greatest wrestlers from the U.S. in recent history. These guys are just great. They're both great competitors, but tonight we're going to see who's going to win in this best of three series. Now, both of these guys have gone up against Frank Chamizo pretty recently, and Kyle Dake's recent match against Jason Nolf, he looked great out there. But between Frank Chamizo and JB and Kyle Dake, these guys kind of have like a triangle going on. It's like a triple rivalry almost. But Jordan Burroughs recently went against Chamizo. I think it was last 2 weeks ago, maybe, at the Mateo Pelicone. And it was a very close matchup. JB almost won, but I believe he lost some criteria or 1 point to Frank Chamizo in a pretty hard-fought match. But Dake, on the other hand, he actually beat Chamizo pretty recently as well in December of 2020, I would like to say. He was, of course, at 79 kgs at the time, which wasn't Chamizo's original weight. So he did have that weight advantage there, and he only won by 1 point. So in that regard, due to common opponents, I would say these guys are pretty even, as they both went against a world champion in Chamizo and both had pretty close matches with him. Due to that, it's kind of a toss-up, but I think it's really gonna come down to three things. The first one is if Kyle Dake can slow JB down. Now, in the past, he's been able to do this by really getting like his underhook defense, slowing down the pace in the match, or just getting a very good sprawl on JB and then going either to a body lock or just hanging out there, holding position, allowing a reset to when they can both get back to their feet and Kyle Dake can shoot in. So if Dake can get to those positions and slow JB down and really have that hard hand fighting he's had in the past, he has a pretty good chance at winning this thing. Second thing to decide who's going to win this matchup, in my opinion, is if JB can get to his wide assortment of takedowns. I mean, the double leg takedown, it's definitely going to work once or twice in this series, but Kyle Dake, he's gone up against it so many times that he definitely knows how to defend it with that double under and really just push off against it and use the underhooks to rip off those hands off his legs. But in a sprint in like the last 30-40 seconds of the match, I feel like JB will be able to get to it. But in the other parts of the match, I think it's going to come down to if JB can get to that low single, if he can get to like an ankle pick, some shrug buys, because if he only is able to get to the double leg, I doubt he's going to be able to win, because Kyle Dake, I mean, you guys saw what he did. He has a great assortment of big throws as well as some 2-point takedowns that he can get to on pretty good wrestlers as well. The third key to victory between both these guys is really going to come down to who's going to be better in conditioning, because all three of these matches I feel like are going to come down to the wire, unless Kyle Dake's able to get some big move or JB's able to get a bunch of turns on like leg laces or something. But I think most of these matches are going to come down to the wire, so it really depends who's going to be in better shape. And from the looks of it, due to Kyle Dake, I mean, he's a lot younger than JB, and JB's this is probably his last Olympic cycle, probably his last year wrestling maybe as well. So I don't really think he's in better shape than Kyle Dake, but I mean, in the past we've seen him get off to a great sprint with still like 20-30 seconds left in the match. We saw that in that Zahid Valencia match. I mean, he was just in better shape than Zahid, who's like 10 years younger than him almost. So I mean, it really comes down to that, in my opinion, because these guys are so well matched against each other. But due to that, and seeing how Kyle Dake has competed in the semifinals and the finals of the Challenge Tournament, I think it's going to be just a bit better than JB, make his first Olympic team, and knock the king off for the first time since 2012. Yeah, let's wrap up our video talking about our predictions between Kyle Dake and Jordan Burroughs. The three keys to victory, to summarize, is going to be if Kyle Dake can slow Burroughs down, if Burroughs can get to an assortment of leg attacks, and third, whoever has the better conditioning. But yeah, it's going to be exciting to watch tonight. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you leave a like, comment down below, and sub if you learned something new. Peace.